Welcome to our tutorial on optimizing your email signature with banners for effective marketing. In this video, we'll explore the benefits of using banners in your email signatures, provide examples, and guide you through the process of adding banners in different positions. So adding a banner to your email signature can significantly enhance your marketing efforts. It serves as a powerful tool to promote your brand, drive traffic to your website, showcase promotions, and create a lasting impression on your recipients. Now, before we begin, it's important to note that we already have our banners designed for this tutorial. However, if you don't have any, you can easily create your own using platforms like Canva. For example, I came in here and I searched for email banner. You could just search for banner, things like that. And you can see these different free templates that we can customize with our information and download them absolutely free. Or you can obtain them from your company's design resources if you need to, okay? But for this tutorial, we already have our banners designed, okay? So once we have those banners, we're gonna go ahead and head inside of our account. And then once we're inside of here, we are going to create a new template from scratch here, from a template. And once we are inside of our templates, I'm gonna go to text only. And then I'm gonna go ahead and scroll down here and we're gonna go with this one here. So I'm gonna select that and click on choose this. Now for position number one, we are gonna place our email banner in the footer of our signature. So to do that, we're gonna click on the bottom right here inside of banking and finance. We are going to click on the plus symbol to add a new option. And then we are going to go over to the right, a footer area. So we're gonna click on that and that's gonna add a footer area with simple text. We're gonna highlight the simple text, delete it. Then we're gonna click inside and click on the image gallery. Now, like I said, I already have my banners designed, but once you have your banner, you are going to click on upload and then choose your file that you have on your computer and then upload it to your account. And then once you have it uploaded, you'll be able to select it from here. So let's go ahead and select my first banner here. And then once I have that selected, we can see it has automatically been added to the footer of my email signature. Now inside of here, I can click on this again. And if I need to, I got these four boxes in each corner and I can come over here and I can resize this to any size that I want. But I like it the way that it was. So I'm gonna put it back just about right there. Now something else we wanna do is we wanna click on the insert link option. And once we do that, we can insert a URL that we want to redirect them to once they click on this image, okay? So this can be anywhere that we want them to be. It can be our website, our landing page. It can be a Calendly invite URL if we want to schedule meetings. It can be anything. So we'll just say that and then site.com and click on insert. So whenever this image is clicked on, they're gonna get redirected to my website. And then of course you wanna give it a name. We'll call this Sig1 and then click on save signature. Now that there is the first option. Now with that banner and the footer there at the bottom, it can effectively enhance the overall visual appeal of your signature, ensuring that it is prominently displayed in every email that you send. And that's option number one. Now moving on to the second option, it's gonna be to place our banner in the email header this time. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna highlight this banner and let's go ahead and trash this and get rid of it. Now this time we are gonna click on Eric J. Bailey and then we are going to click on add option. And this time we're gonna click on header area. And once I do that, again, it puts simple text there. We can highlight that, delete it, and then once again, click inside, click on the image gallery. I already have mine uploaded, so I'm gonna select my image here, and that's gonna place it right there inside of the header. Now again, just like when it was in the footer, we can select it, and we can resize it if we need to, and we can click on the insert link, and then once again, we wanna insert a link that they can visit if they click on our banner. So we're gonna insert that link there. And then once again, you wanna make sure that you save your changes so that you have another copy of your signature. Finally, let's move on to our third option. So let's go ahead and delete this one. We are back to our default signature here. And this time we're gonna look how our banner can be effectively inserted in the middle of our email signature. Now for this position, it is recommended to use a smaller format, such as a small square with the dimensions of 200 by 200, for example, to maintain a balanced and visually appealing signature layout. Now to do that, we're gonna click inside of the middle of the signature here. Then we're gonna click on the add option and we are going to add a space, an empty space just below. And now we have this empty space. And when I click inside of this empty space, we can now click on the image gallery option and then choose our new image that we'd like to insert. Now, let's say you don't like its position. We can select it. And then down here in the bottom right-hand corner, we have move up and move down. So I can click on move down and we can see how that moves down below the next line of text. So maybe I want to put it something like that there. And we can see what that looks like. Now we can also see it looks a little crowded and maybe I want some extra space in between these two options. If so, I'm going to click on my address here. Then I'm going to click on add option. Then I'm going to click on add space just below like that there. And we can see how that looks. And then again, finally, we want to insert our link here. And then once we have our link inserted, we make sure that we want to save it. And finally, to see how this looks and make sure it looks good inside of different browsers and mobile devices, we can click on test up here at the top. And then on the right, we can click on quick preview, open preview, and we can see how that looks on a tablet or a desktop. We can see how it looks on mobile devices just to make sure that it looks good on all the different devices that it's going to be viewed on. So in summary, we've explored the benefits of using banners in email signatures for marketing, demonstrated three different positions for adding banners, and provided step-by-step instructions for each one. We hope this tutorial has empowered you to maximize the impact of your email signatures. Thank you for watching, and we look forward to seeing you in our next video.